In this week's episode, we travel to Portimão, Portugal, with our guest host Nadia Hing, as she talks to Jazeman Jaafar on how it feels to drive a Formula One sexy beast.
Join me in Portugal to watch Malaysia's Jazeman Jaafar put pedal to metal in a Formula One car.
And in our Through the Chicane segment, we head out to Mercedes-AMG PETRONAS Formula One team's factory in Brackley to talk to Paddy Lowe.
If you don't know who Paddy Lowe is, then you don't know much about the Formula One. Today he'll be talking to us about the all-new Silver Arrow F1 W05 Hybrid. So you definitely want to stay where you are.
I'm Nadia Hing.
I'm Jazeman Jaafar.
And this is Motorsports at PETRONAS. Here in the vibrant, historical, cosmopolitan city that is Lisboa, set against the ever-present Atlantic Ocean. And it's said that the heart of this sun-kissed city lies right here at the waterfront, where locals and tourists alike come to sip on coffee and watch the world pass them by. And needless to say, this is a city that takes full advantage of its beautiful weather and location by offering a full, complete sporting calendar throughout the summer.
To accommodate the ever-expansion of motorsports events in Portugal, the Autódromo Internacional do Algarve was built in 2008. Located in the hills near Portimão, this circuit is described as having a roller coaster layout, an exciting and unique track that combines 9 right-handers and 6 left-handers in one fast-flowing white ribbon of tarmac. Today, this circuit will be the private testing ground for Malaysia's Jazeman Jaafar.
Jazeman Jaafar is certainly no stranger to the Malaysian motorsports fraternity. After having clinched the runner-up trophy at the 2012 British F3, the PETRONAS talent development driver is here to do what he does best. Get the adrenaline of any racing junkie going by testing a Formula One car. So don't go anywhere just yet, as I'll be speaking to the racing maverick himself right here at the Autódromo Internacional do Algarve. So it's great to have you on the show, Jazeman, and of course to finally meet you in the flesh.
Thank you.
How have you been?
I've been very good. Training's been going very well. There's a lot of travelling, but I'm enjoying myself.
Great stuff. Now, of course, this is a very exciting time for all of us. After all, Mercedes-AMG PETRONAS Formula One team has invited you for a private testing. You must be over the moon. How do you feel?
I feel overwhelmed. I mean, it's not just a normal test. It's not just any other test. It's a proper F1 test with loads of tyres, loads of running, and the full test team having it here in Portugal, Portimão. Mm-hmm. It's an incredible circuit, incredible facility. So, all in all, the target was to do a minimum of 300 kilometers, and we achieved that by doing 335 kilometers. So, very, very pleased with that.
And what kind of a license do you need to actually drive an F1 car?
You need to get the Formula One Super License. So you need to do a minimum of 300 kilometers with an observer. You need to stop on the marks, and you need to obviously have consistent lap times. To get the approval from FIA to get the license. So you can only get the teams to apply it for you. So I'm very lucky to have Mercedes-AMG PETRONAS to help me.
So tell us more about the Formula One car. What do you love most about it?
I think the Formula One car itself is very special. I mean, as of me today, even driving the 2012 car, it was incredible. The power, the amount of downforce it has, how late you can brake in the corners, it's very, very impressive. But I think what triggers me the most is the amount of people running just one car. I mean, maybe I've got 3, 6, probably 9 engineers, you know, and there's loads of mechanics running around, and you have to know who's who and who's doing what. Yeah. So that's the biggest factor today, really.
There's a lot of teamwork at play, by the sound of it. So, I mean, you're quite different from a lot of other drivers because not only have you driven a lot of cars, but now you've also tried out an F1 car. Mm-hmm. So on a scale of 1 to 10, and be very honest, how difficult was it?
It's not easy.
At a scale of 1 to 10, what would you give it?
I would say 8, maybe.
8 being hard?
8 being hard.
Okay.
Yeah. It's because even going through categories, the cars get, you know, physically tougher, heavier, and Formula One has a lot of speed in the corners, so neck-wise was quite challenging. You've got to hold yourself. There's a lot of buttons in the steering wheel that you need to, you know, do the procedure. So it takes time for it to come second nature. So I'm happy I've completed it. It wasn't easy, but I did it.
So in terms of your current championship, do you think this has actually helped you for your World Series Renault 3.5?
Definitely. Yeah? I mean, driving a bigger, faster car in a much bigger environment helps me develop as a driver. Knowledge, even the lingo, talking to the engineers, you know, a little bit counts as well. So definitely a big boost for my championship. You know, as long as you do the job and, you know, you pinpoint all the problems and you enjoy what you do and work with the engineers, everything just comes to flow.
Cool. So one final question. I know that you've raced, you know, all over the world, from Asia to Europe. Now, I've heard that European drivers are a little bit more competitive. Yeah. Is that true? And how competitive are you?
Very, I'd say.
Which is a good thing.
Or else why would I be racing, right?
That is true.
So I came karting abroad since young, so I got immune to the lifestyle and the competitiveness. Because you have to be competitive, or else don't bother racing, to be honest. And I enjoy the challenge to fight against other European drivers. So,
well, all the best, Jazeman. It's been such a pleasure. And just so you know, as a Malaysian, I think we're all behind you and we'll be rooting for you all the way.
Thank you very much.
Cheers. Today, I have the pleasure of interviewing none other than Puan Anita Azrina Abdul Aziz, the General Manager of Brand Management. Thank you so much for joining us on the show.
Thank you for having me and welcome to Portimao.
It's been gorgeous weather so far and, of course, a very, very exciting experience. Today's, of course, proven that a product of the PETRONAS Talent Development Programme has been recognised for his talent by an international Formula One team. And, I mean, it's such an honour to be here and to test drive a Formula One car. How do you feel about it?
For us, you know, it's always great when we get the news that the team is giving Jazeman the chance to get into a Formula One car. I think we are more excited than Jazeman is.
He's all cool and calm about it.
He's always a cool guy, cool dude there.
With the success of Jazeman Jaafar, Hafiz Sharin, Nabil Jeffrey, and Ramdan Rosli at the world stage, under the talent development program, are you still scouting for a lot of young, fresh talent out there?
I mean, you had the right, you know, description of it. It's successful. The reason why it's successful because we have the four talents that are doing really well this year. Yes. And they're really doing us proud. They're doing the company proud, they're doing PETRONAS proud, they're doing Malaysia and their family proud. We're not there to really scout around and look for more and more talents because it's not about the numbers, it's about having people do well. And we're happy, you know, that the four that we have now are at the stage where they are, really.
But having said that, PETRONAS, first and foremost, is an oil and gas company. And having been involved in motorsports, how would you say this is it's kind of rebranded it in a lifestyle aspect. So what are your thoughts on that?
Well, lifestyle. I think my management committee may not be too happy to hear about that, but, you know, we are really still very much an oil and gas company. Yeah. We have there are four main reasons why we are in Formula One, or you know, motorsports in general. First is of course the brand awareness. You know, and you have good talents. You partner a great team. That's definitely a plus. We want to develop more products. You know, like fuels, our fuels and our lubricants. That's one. That's a second. Thirdly, it's about the talent development, but very important to us. It's not in no order, you know, the four that I have. Why I'm telling you the last part is about the business. Now, it is very important for any company when they invest in something It has a product that delivers on a very long term, mm-hmm. and sustainable. And that's the only way to keep your involvement for us, to get our involvement in Formula One at the stage where it is. Okay. It's to really secure business out of our involvement. Maybe in talent development there's less of it, but definitely our involvement in, say, Cup Prix with Hong Leong and our involvement in Formula One with Daimler Mercedes, that has given us the returns in terms of sales of lubricants. So that's why we are really in Formula One.
Okay. Well, fantastic stuff. And of course, you know, I think, again, as a Malaysian, we're all very, very proud of Jazeman. And we wish you all the best. Thank you so much for sparing the time. It's been an honour. Jazeman Jaafar represents the best of Malaysia. He's both talented and hardworking. And the opportunity to test in an F1 car is just the start of a lifelong dream. And all of us here on the show are going to be cheering him on, wishing him the very best.
As the PETRONAS Technical Performance Consultant, I'm very, very fortunate to be working on with a great group of guys. We have a team of engineers from PETRONAS at the circuit. They have their own area where they work, and I have meetings with them, and we always discuss and try and find out new ways of moving forwards and developing the lubricants in a new way and reaching new limits. And the great thing about Formula One is it's the perfect test bench. So every new idea and development they come up with, they put it in the Formula One car, and I get out and I really push the car to the absolute limit. And in doing that, we're always able to find if there are any flaws or if there's any weaknesses, and that's why we work on those and improve. And really having the technical guys at the circuit is a huge benefit for us.
The introduction of the all-new Silver Arrow F1 W05 Hybrid marks an all-new era for the Formula One. Gone are the days of the 2.4 V8 engines, and in its place is the 1.6 V6 turbo hybrid engines with extensive energy recovery.
With the introduction of the 2014 technical regulations, the team had to adhere to strict new rules and had to work closely with its new technical sponsor, PETRONAS, in developing a fluid technology solution that will power the F1 car for many years to come.
A racing engineer, Paddy Lowe has been active in the Formula One since 1987. He's had a successful career at McLaren for over 20 years. In 2013, Paddy Lowe made that leap and joined Mercedes-AMG PETRONAS Formula One team as the new technical executive director. Ladies and gents, I have here with me Mr. Paddy Lowe. We'll be talking about the Formula One's new regulations as well as the all-new Silver Arrow. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for joining us.
Nice to see you.
Thank you. Well, first up, you are the team technical executive director. Can you tell us a little bit about what that entails and what is it that you oversee?
So I run the team jointly with Toto Wolff. He is the other executive director. So he manages the commercial side, the business side, and I manage the technical and sporting side. So in that sense, between the two of us, we're in charge of the whole team.
So let's talk about the car. Why is it that the F1 W05 hybrid is called the all-new Silver Arrow?
So although Mercedes have been in Formula One for quite a few years, maybe 20 years now, in this latest era developing engines, only since 2010 have Mercedes had their own team. But even within that period, 2010 until 2013, the engine was a carryover. It was a frozen engine. The V8 was developed in the late 2000s and couldn't really be altered. So this year for 2014, we have a new engine, or actually it's called a power unit because it's a hybrid. We'll talk about that a bit later. The power unit is all new, and of course the car is all new, which we do every year, but altogether that means it's an all new car, the first all new Mercedes Grand Prix car since 1954.
Now the heart of the car is the hybrid power unit. The team has also christened the new F1 W05 Hybrid. Now, there's a lot of use of the word hybrid, and you've also added it to the livery. Can you tell us a little bit about this new technology?
Okay, so the engines up until now were purely internal combustion engines, so the V8, which I mentioned earlier. In this year, with the new engine, or what we call power unit, we have hybrid systems attached. So we have an energy recovery system that can recover energy from the rear wheels under braking. We also have an energy recovery unit which can recover energy from the turbocharger, which is taking energy from the exhaust gases. And we have a battery. And so using these three systems, we can manage and flow energy around the system at different points of the lap, and overall produce a far more economic package. So this power unit is saving a lot of fuel for the same performance compared to last year. But the reason we call it hybrid is because this is the term that has come into common use in the automotive industry for engines which have electrical systems attached in order to manage the distribution of energy and the recovery of energy. Mercedes-Benz themselves have hybrid cars now in their model range. There is the S-Class hybrid is the leading example of that. And we want to make a parallel between the technology we use in Formula One and the technology used in the road car.
Now that is very interesting, because I think to a lot of consumers, the word hybrid, they would associate that to being environmentally friendly. Do you think that the Formula One is heading towards that direction?
Not only heading, we've made a lot of progress. So if you imagine the car last year would consume more than 150 kilos of fuel in a race, so that's somewhere around 200 litres. With this new power unit, we only use 100 kilos in a race. So in fact, that's by regulation, it has to be below 100 kilos. So you can see there, 150 to 100 kilos, that's more than a 30% reduction in the fuel that we consume during a race. And yet the performance of that power unit is the same or even better than the engine we had last year in terms of horsepower. So you can see there a huge step made in efficiency and fuel economy, and therefore this is an environmental friendly direction for the sport.
Staying on the topic of power units, the tricky one is all about the turbo power unit. It has this tendency to overheat. Can you talk to us a little bit about the cooling system?
As you can imagine, with an engine that's become more complex, we've added two wholly new systems this year. There's a turbocharger, which we never had before. A turbocharger compresses the inlet air, and you have to cool that air. With what you call an intercooler. So that's a whole new function. We didn't need to cool the charger air before. And then with the hybrid system, or the battery and the motors, electric motors that surround the hybrid system, again, they need quite a lot of cooling. So that's again a new system that we had to provide. So the cooling system on this WO5 is incredibly complicated, much more complicated than we've ever put together before. But I wouldn't say it overheats. The job we've done is to manage all of those demands and create a car and a power unit that cools as necessary. So it's a matter of cooling the car, but doing it efficiently, because every piece of cooling you provide will use some airflow. And airflow being consumed in that way is detrimental to the aerodynamics. It creates drag, it creates other losses of downforce. So the real challenge with this year's car has been to package all of this cooling, all these cooling systems, with the minimum detriment to the aerodynamics.
Well, the team has had such a success so far in the 2014 season. What, in your opinion, would be the key factors that have contributed to your success?
I think there are four elements to that. I think we've been doing a great job with the chassis. Over the last few years, we've seen the improvement of this team on the chassis side, both development of aerodynamics and suspension and all the other aspects of the car has been really on a road to improvement. And we saw in 2013 that we had in many circuits the best car. We won several races. We got pole position many times, actually. So this team was a team on the ascendancy from a chassis perspective. And we've continued that gradient, so a great job done over the winter on the chassis side. And then on the engine side, You know, we've built the best power unit. Mercedes-Benz have, by all accounts, produced the best power unit amongst the three power unit manufacturers. Then I add on top of that is really the combination between those two, the way in which we've worked between Brackley and Brixworth as a works team to put those two things together and get the best out of each. Because it's all about optimum packaging for efficiency and low weight. So that combination is my third thing.
Right.
And finally, I think we've just got two most fantastic drivers in Nico and Lewis. Right. You know, they're really two of the best drivers in Formula One, and as a team lineup, absolutely without question, the best lineup in Formula One, and we're seeing that play out every weekend.
Yes, I totally agree. Well, we're very excited, and we wish you guys all the best. Thank you so much for taking the time to be with us today. I think we've learned a lot, and I'm sure our viewers are very enlightened by your presence here. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It's a great pleasure.
With the collective effort between Brackley, Brixworth, and Petronas, the Mercedes-AMG Petronas Formula One team has got a car that is a class above the rest. Here's to many more podium finishes, and we wish them all the best. Don't forget to log on to www.petmos.com.my for all the information about your favorite teams, drivers, and race results. My name is Darren Lee, and this has been Motorsports at Petronas.
Where locals and tourists alike come to sit on coffee flat, sorry. Jazeman Jaafar is certainly no stranger to the Malaysian Motorsports. Oh, no.
If you don't know who Patty Lowe is, then you should be watching The Kardashians. We have a big bucket of chicken. The introduction of the all-new Silver Arrow in its place. Nice China.